How can a hearing aid's price vary by 100% depending on where you get it? What's going on here? Let's get into it. Hey guys, Jeff here at Zip Hearing, and today I want to talk about why hearing aid prices are, well, all over the place. It's one of the most common points of confusion that I see among hearing aid buyers, so I want to try to shine some light on what's going on here and why this happens. Now, in this video, I'm talking about prices for hearing aids, which are thousands of dollars. I'm not talking about amplifiers, which are hundreds of dollars. If you want to compare those two things separately and why those are priced so differently, that's the video for you. This video is about pricing for actual hearing aids from the leading brands and why prices for these hearing aids vary so much depending on where you buy them. First, let me show you what I'm talking about. And if you do any research on hearing aid pricing, you will quickly see this for yourself. I'm gonna pull up a couple websites and show you prices for the same exact hearing aid. It's one of the best hearing aids out right now. It's the Phonak Audéo Paradise 90. On the left here, you see a price of $1,669, and on the right, we have a website that tracks national average prices of hearing aids, showing that this hearing aid usually retails for $3,685. So there you have it. Between the two, you've got a more than 100% difference in price. So what are you supposed to make of that? How can that be? There are two reasons for this huge difference in pricing. There's actually more than two, but these are the two biggest. First is the amount of service that's included with your purchase. Oftentimes when you pay this price, you're getting a lifetime service package from a local business, meaning, you know, 4 years down the road, whatever it might be, you need your hearing aids reprogrammed or cleaned, whatever. Just take them into the hearing center. They're serviced at no charge. Now, hearing aids are not a high volume product for that local business, so the markup has to be high enough on each sale to ensure that the business can keep their doors open for the next several years so they can fulfill their service obligation to you. I'm not saying that's the right way to do it, that's just the economics of why pricing is that way. You know, if you don't sell a ton of volume of a product, what you do sell needs to be marked up enough to make sure you can keep your doors open to provide service to everyone that's bought from you. Now, at this price point, the company is just mailing hearing aids to you and doing service remotely. That means, you know, they don't need to have that local store. They're not doing routine service tests or routine hearing tests or cleaning the hearing aids, fitting verification, physical modifications, in-office repairs, whatever it might be. You know, there's a bunch of stuff that goes along with having hearing aids, just keeping them running right. So their service obligation to you is a lot lower than that local office's. It involves fewer people and less overhead expense, hence the cheaper price. So, as you might expect, there is some downside. At some point, in the course of owning your hearing aids, to get the most out of your hearing aids performance wise, and to get repairs and service done in the fastest and most convenient way, you're going to want a local provider who can service you. I mean, and this company knows that. It's not a secret. I mean, they even tell you on their website, hey, you can take these hearing aids to any local provider. It's not entirely true, and oftentimes it's not real cost effective, but that's a topic for a whole nother video. If you're interested in some of the pros and cons of buying online with remote only service, that's a good video to watch. So to summarize, the first reason for pricing discrepancy is the amount of service the seller provides with the product or with your purchase. But there's another big factor that contributes to wildly varying prices, and that is wildly varying prices that, or wildly varying wholesale prices that retailers pay. A retailer that sells a ton of hearing aids, like an online company, can easily pay half as much for hearing aids from the manufacturer than that local provider pays. You know, it's like most things, you buy more of a product or you buy a higher quantity, you get a lower price or you get a better price. So when you combine those two factors, the price the company pays for the hearing aid and then the service plan they include with the hearing aid, that's why prices can just be all over the place. So to summarize, I think it's safe to say that's not a super competitive price. I mean, it's technically competitive. That's what most people are paying, but you can do way better. But I also think it's fair to say that even though this is a much cheaper option, much better price, the sacrifice of not having local care is not worth it for a ton of people. So what do you do? Well, here's a couple ideas. First, if price is the most important factor, which I can understand that, these things are a fortune, you just buy from one of these internet companies that mails the hearing aids to you. But you got to be aware that there's probably going to be a point in time where you're going to need or want a local provider, more than likely. And they may not touch hearing aids that were bought online or will charge such high prices that it like totally eats away at any of the savings you realized through buying online. Another option would be you talk to a local provider that has these prices, but see if they're willing to put you on a more like pay-as-you-go or a la carte type service plan where you pay a lower upfront price for the hearing aids and then pay something like, you know, an hourly rate, like $50 an hour or something, whatever it might be, for future appointments if and when you need them. Or not if, you're going to need future service appointments. This is probably the better and safer way to save money for most people. Because one thing I didn't mention about this option of buying online with remote care is a lot of hearing aid manufacturers don't even allow their hearing aids to be sold online with remote care without the involvement of a local provider. And if you check Phonak's website about buying that way, you'll see that you may not even have a warranty included with your purchase. I mean, the retailer may say you do, but you can read Phonak's website for yourself there. That's a topic for a whole nother video, but definitely something to be aware of. So again, for most people, you're going to get better results and have a less risky transaction or less risky buying process. It's a less risky purchase if you work with a local company rather than getting hearing aids through the mail. And if you want to find out if there are any hearing providers near you that will help you get hearing aids at a lower price than this full retail price, and then just put you on a pay-as-you-go service plan, just enter your info here and we'll call you and let you know. So I hope that clears things up a little bit and has given you something to think about. I know that buying hearing aids and kind of wrapping your head around all your options and this whole industry can feel totally overwhelming. That's my phone number. Please feel free to call me and talk to me. I'm always happy to chat or just post a comment. I usually respond within 24 hours. All right, that's a wrap for this video. Hit the like button and I will see you on the next one.